In January of 2020, Maxi Villavicencio Pulian went to her ancestral home in Taal, Batangas to help clean up the devastation from the Taal volcano's eruption that month. But as she swept up the debris, she learned about her great-great-grandmother and an idea exploded. Pulian went on to write, "Fierce Filipina."
Being in Taal made me realize that the houses that Gliceria, my great-great-grandmother, had, you know, were converted to museums, and her name is the main street. Also, her monument, her statue is there, and being in Taal made me realize that children probably see her name all over the place but don't know what she did. So during lockdown, at the height of COVID, I took the time to do some research and put a book together with my three nieces who helped me out, and then hired a fabulous illustrator in Manila, Jill Arteche, and we finally got it out into the public.
The children's book tells the story of Gliceria Marella-Villavicencio, regarded as a national hero along with her husband Eulalio Villavicencio. They helped provide finances for Philippine revolutionaries, even using their home to hold secret meetings with leaders such as Andres Bonifacio.
I was able to see what she did, a lot of her connections to Jose Rizal, Emilio Aguinaldo, and some other revolutionary or men who were in the revolution, and see how it connected to the larger picture of Philippine history. I wanted to ensure that this story came from the women's perspective, and really just wanted to do anything I could to make this a source of inspiration, given the height of hate crimes taking place right now.
Despite local monuments and preserved homes, Villavicencio is often referred to as a forgotten hero of the revolution.
That's the problem, is that I don't think we look at them as being as prominent. Definitely growing up here in the States, I had no awareness of them. And frankly, and I'm embarrassed to say this, I did not even realize that my great-great-grandmother and her husband contributed to the revolution so much to the point that they are considered heroes. That helped me in my connection with the Philippines and the people of the Philippines.
Over 100 years later, Villavicencio's descendants have gone on to live lives of service. For Pulian, who does social work with U.S. military veterans, learning about her ancestors' contributions to the Philippine Revolution inspired her even more. Along the same family tree is Pulian's cousin, John Hernandez, who recently won a Super Bowl as the Los Angeles Rams physical therapist.
It's within our family's nature to always take care of others. And I think it's really in our, I don't just think it actually, I believe it is in our DNA to do whatever we can to live a life of excellence, but also ensure that our actions, especially our daily human-to-human actions, are always in service of others. I do think that was passed down to us from our ancestors.
Fierce Filipina, along with some merchandise, is available online and will soon be released digitally. With every copy that makes its way into readers' hands, Pulian is confident that the story of her great-great-grandmother's heroism will live on. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.